Kia ora mai tātou, ko ai tēnei, huri tēnei no Ngāti Tūwharetoa, Te Atihaunui-a-Papaarangi, Ngāi Tūhoe, Ngāti Kahungunu ki Wairoa, rawa ko Rongomaiwahine, ko Heni Unwin tōku ingoa, he kairangahau ahau ki Cawthron Institute. I am a research scientist at Cawthron Institute, and my name is Heni Unwin.
Kia ora tātou, ko Te Rerekohu Tuterangiwhiu ahau, he uri ahau no te taitokerau, he uri hoki no Taranaki, he kairangahau Māori ahau, ki Cawthron Institute. I am a Mātauranga Māori researcher in the Māori development team at Cawthron.
My current research, I look at aquaculture, microplastics and emerging contaminants. We're developing technologies for aquaculture farms. So we're looking at cameras on the farm, we're looking at underwater robotics, we're looking at measuring the gaping behaviour of mussels and getting that technology out there so that you can be at your desk instead of going to your farm to find out what is happening in the in your aquaculture farm. And then I also look at microplastics. I'm currently doing my master's at the University of Canterbury and I'll be looking at the effects of microplastics on mussels.
My current projects at the moment focus around enabling the ahikā perspective in biosecurity, as well as exploring traditional concepts of marine and aquatic cultivation throughout not only our mahi and Māori, but connecting over to our practitioners in Hawaii. Part of that is about reclaiming those spaces of cultivation and aquaculture. And the other part is enabling us as Māori to be able to explore and develop the infrastructure for what Māori aquaculture could look like in 2035, 2040, 2050. And that may look like Te Ao Māori hou. But my projects are around bringing Mātauranga Māori out of the shadow and into the light of the now. I never wanted to be a researcher. The goal for me was to try and be a practitioner of kaupapa Māori and Mātauranga Māori things. And through my development and my upbringing, I quickly saw that there aren't really any pathways for those kinds of kaupapa and for young Māori who want to be kaitiaki, for example, to go and do those things formally. So research for me is a necessary tool to enable that kind of a pathway. And that's why I became a researcher.
I have known since I was 10 years old because I was fortunate enough to go on a trip with my family to Rarotonga and I went snorkeling there, and as soon as I dove down I was just like, what are all of these things? Why is this here? Why isn't this in New Zealand? From that moment I was just fascinated with that world, and so that's when I decided I wanted to be a marine scientist and come through and do research science, and then it just sort of backed up with all of the other kaupapa and all of the things that I saw around me of, the world not being exactly right, or it's getting poisoned by a whole lot of different things. So it was just coming back and I could feed back into that and help it.
Māma noho tēnei māku. When I became a parent, because you suddenly become faced with the realization that you have to create the environment in which your tamariki flourish in. That's taking me down a path around, I suppose, the simple things around having scientists that speak Māori, having scientists that are able to articulate both perspectives, Te Ao Māori, Te Ao Pāke, having the freedom to think of these types of ara as pathways for total immersion tamariki. All of those things become, I suppose, apparent as you start to think, how am I creating an ao where my tamariki's opportunities are at their own disposal? So I think for me, becoming a papa and really wanting to influence the world that my tamariki developing kind of brought me down this path. And it was a path that I think not very many Māori travel down. So it was new territory, and to be able to influence that new territory was exciting for me.
I think, you know, for most people, a significant person in their lives is their parents. My mother, she is Pākehā. She was born in Timaru. She met my papa, who's Māori, from born and raised in Ratanapa. So they come from two really contrasting worlds, but my mother is one of the most compassionate and lovely people that you'll ever meet. And when she had us kids, me and my brother, she actually learnt te reo Māori and made sure that we went to kohanga reo, we went to kurarua reo, made sure that we were proud to be Māori. They're two of the most significant people in my life and have changed me and in short instilled in me all of these qualities, because they both came together for us children in their own separate ways, in their own beautiful ways.